lot of ways, neighborhoods are jungles. And what we've always done is to try to sustain and uplift the noble animals as we see ourselves as the noble animals. And the badass animals, they got no sympathy from me.
I looked up the definition of legacy in the dictionary, and legacy is a gift given by someone who has passed away. A gift. I think about all the gifts my dad has given to me, to his family, to his community. He might not be here in body, his gifts still remain, and his lessons still remain.
To me, the future is, you want to revitalize something on a creative basis, you must give the creative entrepreneur a stake in the long-term action. Artists lead you to the neighborhood, and then they get priced out. That's the history of gentrification. Gentrification. Gentrification means give them a stake to stay there a long time.
Goldman Properties started in 1968. My dad and my mother bought a brownstone on the Upper West Side of New York.
I was making about $150 a week. He was making $125. He painted the halls, he put the loft in, and we were in business. Then he came to Soho. Everyone thought he was crazy. It was dark, dreary, and dangerous.
He was not afraid to think outside the box and push the envelope and be his own man.
We bought a critical mass of real estate. We opened restaurants.
That was an inspirational moment. It was the beginning of my new model, opening restaurants to ignite neighborhoods. Because I knew the neighborhood was great. It just needed an ignition. It needed something to bring thousands of people here, fast. My role was to demonstrate what I wanted to do and then share that enlightenment with my neighbors, my competitors, and hope that they could benefit like I benefited. I wanted to raise the water levels everywhere.
In 1986, Dad went to Miami. He turned the corner on Ocean Drive and Fifth Street. It was old people in crack houses, but he saw what could be the American Riviera.
We never go into a neighborhood without getting critical mass ownership and site control of a property. And it's usually 18 properties, more or less. But that's what you need to ignite a change.
I look at South Beach, the architecture that's been restored and preserved. That's what speaks to me the most. My dad and our company were changing the course of history for the city of Miami.
He was able to make magic happen, and that was the second time.
You want statistical evidence of that? Look at the police records from when we were in to now. Take a look at the tax rolls, when we were in and where it is now. And the city, as a result of that, has provided better school system, better policing, better hospitals. We've added to the economy, and we've given, over the years, I don't know how many thousands of jobs we've developed as a result of our input.
I wanted to chat with you about an idea I have for the future. As far as I'm concerned, I haven't done enough yet. That's truly how I feel, by the way. I just feel insane. Crazy bastard that I am.
We talk about life, and there's no one that wanted to live life more than my father. My dad was diagnosed with idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, and the only cure was a double lung transplant.
I've never met anyone with as much courage as Tony. He was determined not to be afraid.
After he got his lung transplant, those were the most productive years of his life.
The Wynwood just sort of happened organically.
Joey said, this is a really, really interesting place that we need to look at. And my dad saw the possibility that this could become one of the most important neighborhoods in the world for public art.
I said, let's take street art and create an international outdoor museum.
Sending out electricity and imagery that elevates.
He'd be the warrior and I was the worrier. I'd be running around with the Purell and he'd be embracing everyone.
I should be doing this to you.
He was just a character. Oh, he had so much style.
And hopefully it's not ruining my code, but I don't think it is, and I don't really care.
It was so funny, so entertaining, never boring.
Very refreshing. It's almost like taking a shower in blue spaghetti.
Life was really precious, and every breath was important to him. Every minute of life was important to him.
Detroit is a place that I've always been intrigued about coming to, but never came.
I would love to curate this.
There's so much open and empty land here that I've experienced. There is a great opportunity. What urban center in America has so much open land? Now, you may consider it if you look at it to say it's blight, but I look at it and I say, well, look at these fields of green that can be parks, that can be public art facilities, that can be community spaces, that can be community agriculture.
He had this real optimism that came through in his vision.
This is the most exciting spot I've seen in Detroit.
Yeah,
it's absolutely inspiring. Yeah. It's the essence of place. Yeah. And that's what I say makes a city.
Very.
I'm quite moved.
He lived as long as he did and was able to do as much as he did because of his spirit. You know, that driving spirit is very powerful, and he had it. He left his energy here. He gave it to all of us.
I think the ULI Award to my dad would have been like getting an Academy Award. It's really total and complete recognition for the creativity, the passion, the drive, and the energy that he had.
Legacy is this amazing gift, and my father showered all of us with lots of gifts. If he were here tonight, he would look out upon all of these amazing people, his friends, his family, and he would ask, what is your legacy? What are your gifts? What are you going to share with the rest of the world?
Take a risk. Believe in yourself. Believe in your team. Always be honest. Never give up.